Rachel and Steve. Today you are entered as individuals. Today you are entered as individuals, but you will leave here as husband and wife, blending your lives, expanding your family ties, and embarking on the grandest adventure of human interaction. Y'all look at each other.
What? Oh, we're supposed to look at each other, he said.
The story of your life together is still yours to write. Marriage is founded upon sincerity and understanding, which leads to tolerance, confidence, and trust. It involves respect for each other's feelings and weaknesses and faults. You believe that those qualities which have attracted you both to each other can best be developed during a life spent together. A happy marriage will enable you to establish a home with love and stability, where your family and friends will always be welcome, and which will be a base from which the influence of your shared and, we hope, strengthened life today can extend. Every day you live, learn how to receive love as much as understanding as you give it. Find things within yourself, then you can share them with each other. Do not fear this love. Have an open heart and a sincere mind. Be sincerely interested in each other's happiness. Be constant and consistent in your love. From this comes security and strength. And that we love deeply becomes part of us on this day of your marriage. Try to commit yourselves fully and freely to each other. The Bible has given us what may be the world's best definition of what it means to love. I'd like to share with you a well-known passage from 1 Corinthians 13 and offer it as a model for you for the new life you are creating here today. Love is patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and it is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's faults, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope. It is always ready to endure whatever comes. True love does not come to an end. Love is the reason why this day was chosen by you both to begin your lives together. And love is the reason why you both will give all the hearts for the good of each other. Love is the reason that together you will become one. One in hope, one in believing in life, one in sharing the coming years. Before you are joined in marriage, I am here to remind you of the solemn and enduring nature of the relationship into which you are about to enter. Do you, Steve, take Rachel to be your lawfully wedded wife from this day forward, to have and to hold, forsaking all others, for better or for worse, for richer and poorer, in sickness and health, to love and cherish for as so long as you both shall live?
I do.
And do you, Rachel, take Steve to be your lawfully wedded husband from this day forward, to have and to hold, forsaking all others, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and health, to love and cherish for as long as you both shall live? Now, I ask that God bless these rings that Steve and Rachel will exchange as a symbol of their love and fidelity. Okay. May I have the rings, please? Thank you, sir.
Oh, that's cool.
Sorry. Aww. Steve? Go.
Oh, how am I supposed to put it on?
Go ahead and do that halfway thing.
What is it?
Oh my God!
Does it go this way or
that
way?
May these rings be blessed as a symbol of this affectionate union. These two lives are now joined in one unbroken circle. Wherever they go, may they always return to one another in their togetherness. May these two find in each other the love for which all men and women yearn. May they grow in understanding and in compassion. May the home in which they establish together be such a place of sanctuary that many will find there a friend. May these rings on their fingers symbolize the touch of the spirit of love in their hearts. Steve, in placing this ring on Rachel's finger, repeat after me.
With this ring,
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
Okay. Rachel. In placing this ring on Steve's finger, repeat after me.
With this ring,
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with all that I am,
and all I have,
I honor you.
Okay.
In acknowledgement of this holy purpose and the power of this occasion, let us pray. Dear Father in heaven, as we come before your throne with our offering of love, we ask you to bless this union of marriage. We pray that you will be the third strand that binds them together and cannot be broken. May you be the guiding light shining on this chosen path of lifelong commitment to each other and you. Amen. Steve and Rachel, throughout this wedding ceremony, you have vowed to love and remain steadfast and loyal to one another as you stand before your friends and family. You have each formalized and sanctified your bond by exchanging wedding vows and rings. May your love be eternal and undying. As you begin your married life together, hold close to the words that you have spoken to each other today. Life isn't always an easy road, as you both know. Rely on your faith and in the promises that you make today to help you through those times. Ask God to grant you the gifts of caring and understanding in your life together, allowing that each may be the other source of strength in need, and a counselor in times of uncertainty, a comfort in times of sorrow, and a companion in your joys. Steve and Rachel have consented together in marriage before this company, have pledged their faith and declared their unity, and are now joined in mutual esteem and devotion. What God hath here joined together, let no one set asunder. By the authority vested in me, by the state of Texas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Yes, you may kiss the bride. Yay.
It is now my great honor to be the first to present Mr. and Mrs. Steve and Rachel Laus.
Never been one to ask for help. If I need a mountain moved, I'm moving myself. I ain't the church pew regular, twice on Sunday, quote you the scripture kind. I'm far from a preacher, but I'm a believer. 'Cause every single day before I